wasn't the delivery. Oh. It was dropped by Zebana. He never makes those kind of mistakes. And they were hoping for somebody to come to finish it off. But there was no proof. Yeah, a rare mistake by Ariel Zebana. And lucky he did not get punished for that one win.
Exactly. Not coming from the bright side. If there was a blue jersey coming from the bright side, I think it's...
But here comes Dimbale once again with quality conducting. Nice. And he gets past his marker. He's still trying his luck. He could not get past Munawa. And Munawa, there he is now. Getting the better. And finding Kawatsikwa. Sweeps it back. Gets the return. Mudua now. Sends it upfield for. And still with a chance. With Mambari with his first touch, or the delivery was not too good. Still a chance for Dynamo here! A Dynamo Tamale! What did I say? What did I say? Nobody here now! Sorry for getting high levels! And look at the emotional Lloyd Mutasa! What did I say? He had just been in there for how many minutes? Maybe two or three, and just have a look at this. It was just a loose ball from nothing, and Matsimba Mambare was scoring against my Raiders, hasn't he?
You're there, Officer. You're my name.
It's confusing there.
And it's silver, yeah, it's a good one.
Because according to the referee, it's not a good one. It's not a good one from the official. There's nothing wrong with that. That's a clear goal. Masimba Mambare, just like you said,
he will always be there, just trying to send his own piece of argument. The Dynamo's captain has been at Dynamo for some time now. Brian Banda who struck the ball, but I think it was straight at Matea Unga. Well, the Dynamo supporters will say that it was a clinical save by Matea Unga. Well, that is why there are always two sides to the story. Here's Munawa telling his Highlander story now. Oh, Matea Unga, goal! No! Unbelievable! But the flag had already gone up. It wouldn't have mattered anyway. But how did the Prince anyhow up one wide, the flag had already gone up, but really, you don't leave this 25 unattended like they had done
it. You don't leave a player in the mode of Prince.
The Prince, that is the impressive Emmanuel Mandiranga. Oh, what a matchup this former FC Platinum player has had. He swept past his marker. Oh, by the impressive Dynamo's number 7, there he is again. Oh, he has played his hand out and winning. Unlucky Mandiranga won.
I don't know what should the boy do to get a goal. The goalkeeper was beaten all systems out. It was written goal all over. By the moment it left his left boot, I think he had done a messy like thing there, Charles, from the edge of the box, beating his mother for dead and getting a left footer to the far post, goalkeeper beaten, but the upright just denied the young man, unfortunately for him.
And the tenders came around and really set the cat amongst the pigeons. Let's see, Matea Unga instructing his defense. Here is Brian Banda. Ah, it was a poor one. He couldn't have set the cat amongst the pigeons like that. I don't know what he was thinking about. Surely he would have done better, and they know it. They know that he could and should have done better. So it remains at 1-0, and Matea Unga is the happier of the two. Ivan telling out to his true grit and determination. Brian Banda gets ready to dispatch the second corner kick for Highlanders. Oh, that one should have been 1-1. I'm sure we'll have a chance to watch that one again. It was a poor corner by Brian Thunder and Dynamo's Mount a counter raid, but squatting again. The last 5 minutes or so have belonged to Iboso Iboso as they turn on the power, trying to rack up the intensity and get an equalizer here. Oh, there was his territory. He was going for the far corner, but boy, was he miles away with it. Goal, as we see, we was hard down as the referee. Brighton Chimene was there on top of Kings. If anything looks like scoring, it's this black and white army here. Yes, they look like the likely scorers, but not like that. You can't do it like that. They get a lucky jam because it goes out to give away a corner kick. And there is the Independence Cup there. That was a substitute with Denzel Kumalo, a number 10, who took the corner, who had the initial work. And time will come on a counter. Islanders have thrown everybody forward. And what can Dynamo do here? Swept into no man's land. And the Blue Army had risen up. He was going for goal number two. But I think he hurried his effort. He should have taken more time. He hurried his order and buried it into his hands. Take your pick. As they come on a counter raid. But Ariel Sibanda again, just making sure. Playing the Bravo type of football now. Yes, remember the one from Barcelona to Manchester City who had a couple of howlers, but now he's back in the Manchester City lineup. I'm talking about Bravo. And Sibanda, I think for the past quarter of an hour, has been holding his foot like a Bravo. And Mateonga also holding his foot here. And they love it. The Blue Army does love it. Mateonga's clearance. What a poor one. Swept away by the Highlanders' radar. Swept away again by Muroiwa. Free kick to Highlanders. Under 3 minutes to go. And Highlanders get the key equalizer. They're still powering forward. Still with a chance. Swept back. And St. Piri takes over. Pushes it back now. To Tendai Block for header here. And away by Mateonga. That was the one and only Prince. Who could have delivered the equalizer? The Highlanders are not finished here. Oh no, they are not. Oh, for now they are. My word. What a perfect header by Mutoma. And what an equally brilliant keep away by Mateonga. Another chance here. Unlucky. Oh, this final has really lived up to expectations. Woo! No time to get your breath here. Even in the community press, even they understand. I don't think they are catching their breath tomorrow at all. More, other than Tico has got a thing on as well. But to get something going, now Tico's delivery, who climbed? It was a Glovu, another delivery. Who climbs it this time? And Dynamo's put it away. Oh, but Highlanders just finding on the pressure. We've got about 30 seconds of normal time. Oh, there should be some couple of minutes to be added on as Highlanders look for the elusive equalizer. Oh, we thought it had come there from Rotary Motoma, but Mateonga rose the airborne to tip it out. And can Dynamo finish it off? Can they finish it off? And Ariel Sibanda, you're off his line. Can Dynamo finish it off here? No, they can't. Oh, they thought they had. Oh, what a final. Corner kick number two for Dimari. Let's have a look at it again. Maybe the referee would have been a bit harsh because there was nothing he could do. He couldn't move his hand away. But anyway, Dynamo has got the free kick. It's now or never for the black and white army. Because with this world should be the last attack. Can Highlanders make this the last attack here? A chance for Highlanders. They could not dispatch that one again.
That is definitely the last kick of the game when everybody